Hello, this is Norm from Harla Penguin. Today I will show you how to set up a physics simulation in Blender and to record the simulation as keyframes, which can be used in an animation. So before we get started, here's a quick example I put together. So the first step in the process is to switch from Blender Render or Cycles Render to Blender Game. This will allow us to set up the physics simulation. We will delete the default cube, press Shift A, Mesh, Plane, scale the plane up. We also want to make the plane a little bit of a ramp. So I will press R to rotate, X for the X axis, and 3 to give it 3 degrees of rotation. Press Enter. Look at it from the side view, looks pretty good. Now we will add the ball. So deselect the plane, Shift A, Mesh, UV Sphere. Scale it down to make it a little bit smaller. Set the shading to smooth. All right, now to add the physics. With the sphere selected, go over here to the right, scroll all the way to the right, and select the Physics tab. We are going to change the physics type to Rigid Body. Now, as you see, there are several different physics types that we could select. Soft Body, which would make it more like a jello. Dynamic, which means that the object is impacted by gravity, but it does not roll. Static are objects that really don't do very much. They aren't impacted by gravity. Things do collide into them, but they don't change shape based on the collision. For us, we want rigid body. It means that the ball will fall. It will be pulled down by gravity. As soon as it hits a plane, it will roll. For more information on the physics type, you can look at the Blender manual at blender.org. So let's start the simulation and see what it looks like. So as you can see, it hits the plane and then it rolls down. Great. All right. So looks good rolling down the plane, but what if we want to make this a little bit more interesting? Say we want the ball to bounce when it hits the plane. For that, we will select the Material tab, New Material, scroll down to Physics. For the bounciness, we will change the elasticity, and in this case, we'll change it to 0.8, and we will decrease the friction to 0.3. Now, if you run the simulation, you'll see that not much has changed. And the reason for that is we also want to change these settings on the plane. So select the plane, select the Material tab again, select New, and on this one, set the elasticity again to 0.8 and the friction to 0.3. And if you run the simulation now, you will see that it bounces, which is exactly what we want. So we have a bouncing ball. Let's add just a few more balls. And we'll select a few of these. I'll say rotate Z just to rotate them around. And now, if we run the game engine again, we'll see that they bounce into each other. And they roll down. Looks good. So now that we have the physics set up, we want to turn this from a simulation into an animation. So go to the top, and the first item to check is frames per second in the World tab. This allows us to select whether we want the simulation to run at normal speed, slow motion, fast motion. So for this, we will set this to 24, since we want the animation to be normal speed. The 60 frames would be slow motion if we wanted to show the simulation in slow motion. In our case, we want it to run normal speed, set it to 24, which will also match our animation frame rate. and we're going to look at it with 24, just verify that everything runs correctly. And as you can see, one of the balls falls through. So let's go over here. And let's increase the physics substeps to give us more accurate results. And as you can see now, they correctly bounce and roll. All right, now we will go to game, record animation, and this will record a keyframe for the position of each of the balls in the simulation. We start the game engine, and we will let it run all the way until the balls fall off. Press escape. And now each of these balls has keyframes associated with it. So we'll flip over to Cycles Render and we will pull up the graph. And as you can see, there are keyframes that are assigned. This is perfect. If we press Alt-A to run the animation, it runs exactly as it was simulated. And it will run this way every time now. So we can make this interact with other characters, with other physics, say water, in a very predictable way. And that's it. Thank you for watching. We'd love to have your comments below.